AM. Now, back to First Look with Scott Cox on News Talk 1180 and the new 96.1 KERN.
We are back. It is a First Look program. It's News Talk 1180, the new 96.1 KERN. We're streaming live on the internet at Bakersfield.com. 842-KERN's phone number, 842-5376. Coach Rod Barnes has joined us on the program. Here is what you did for a lot of people. I don't know what it was like in the restaurants and bars and everywhere all across town, people watching on their TV. I was at the Racquet Club working my fingers to the bone, and there were kids from all over the world, and they had that game on the TV there, who were glued to that thing. And when you guys were up by six, there were multiple leads in that game, man.
It was.
And you had all of those people, I mean, literally standing up. Nobody was sitting on the – everybody was standing up just rooting you guys on.
Wow.
That's a heck of a gift to give to people right
there. You
know,
Scott, the tough thing about that, you know, we don't get a chance to see that or enjoy that as much. I mean, obviously we've got some coverage and some, you know – some of our TV people got a chance to be in some of the bars and anything, but really when you're coaching, you don't get all of that to the end. Like, yeah. Really, I started looking in the newspaper as far as looking back because, you know, when we were at the WAC tournament, obviously you're not thinking about the newspaper here back in Bakersfield. You're thinking about, hey, we got to win tomorrow night. And then we win, and then all of you thinking about is Oklahoma. So it was nice for me just the other day to get back and look and see the excitement that was in town.
Sure,
and see
yeah.
what people were thinking. And,
well, it was real, man.
And it was a great feeling.
You know, and speaking of that excitement too, when you guys were in Oklahoma City, and I was talking with Corey quite regularly because we were doing getting ready for the radio broadcast and the whole thing. And I said, "How is it there? I mean, what's the excitement like?" And he was just saying, everything was first class. Everything was clean. The locker rooms were immaculate. Everything. What did you see in the eyes of your kids there when they were in this, what Corey described to be a cathedral of basketball? What was it like? How excited were they just to be in that atmosphere?
Well, as a coach, you could see the change, you know, and that's a great thing that in coaching, you know, as you start to see kids mature, you know, it's almost like a dream. You start to experience, and you write in that dream. You see the reality of all the hard work. You see all the things that I've been, you know, and the coaches have been pushing. All of a sudden, you say, guys, this is the reason why. This is what you wanted to do. It's what everybody, every student-athlete in basketball wants to be in the NCAA tournament. Now you experience it. It is the greatest event almost. I mean, obviously in collegiate athletics. But, you know, outside maybe of the Super Bowl, it may be the greatest event that goes on because there are so many people involved with it. You got 68 teams that are involved in it. You got another 100 or 200 and some that are saying, we should have been there. We wanted to be there. So it's just a great deal. And to see our kids, you can just see it in their eyes. It's almost like maybe a child being 3 years old and they get their favorite Christmas gift.
Yeah.
It just does something to you. And I saw that happen. And our guys will never be the same after this experience.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That is just super cool.
We talked a little bit about, you know, the one of the knocks on the tournament is that it sort of diminishes the regular season at times. But, I mean, that's more of like TV ratings issue. Mm-hmm. But I kind of felt like looking at your schedule going into this thing, that your season was defined by that little difficult road trip stretch. You had to play Fresno State, South Dakota, Dartmouth, I think, was on that schedule as well. It could have been very easily been a difficult thing, but you guys came through that very, very well. At what point did you think this team's going to be pretty good and we're going to be okay going through the WAC tournament?
Well, really, I thought last spring, I told our guys, I thought last spring because what happened, I saw us be very disappointed. Mm-hmm. The first year we lost to New Mexico State, we almost like, hey, man, we played good.
Yeah.
Good job.
Right.
You know, last year I saw Ali and Kev and Brett Rapp and Jalen Arrington hurt.
Right.
And I told the coaches, I said, we're going to win now because it actually means that much to them that I'm not saying anything, but they actually hurt. And then once we got back and they started to work, I kept saying this team is going to be good because I thought we had great leadership. I thought we could do some things that other people really couldn't do as far as with Ali and Kevin. And But when you start talking about the season, that stretch there probably was a defining moment that I started to say, hey, we're going to be okay.
Right.
Because we're on the road. You got every reason to give in. Like 4 to 5 games were on the road. We went 4-1 out of that stretch. That's when that stretch kind of said, hey, man, this team might do pretty well. So in the season of the games, that was the time. But last year during this time, during the spring, that's when I started to say, we're close. And as I told our team yesterday, I mean, it was our first meeting back. We had spring break last week. I said, listen, guys, this team that we're coaching next year is an NCAA team. But between now and November, every single guy in this room has to get better.
Right.
If we don't get better, we'll be a good team. And people will come out and watch us. For us to be an NCAA team, we've got to do that between now and November. And if we can do that, then we'll be back on track.
I thought one of the things that defined your team, too, was that, you know, when you watched New Mexico State kind of walk around the Orleans and the WAC tournament, you're like, man, this team is athletic. This team is gigantic. you know, they got a 7-footer. They got a 6'9" guy who can play all over the place.
Yeah.
You guys weren't afraid of him at all.
No.
And it was clear from the first moment you took they're not afraid of him. This is going to be an interesting game.
Right.
That's what it was.
I'll tell you what happened. And I thought, we felt like the game, we gave the game away here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we led from start to finish. We got a 14-point lead with like 12 minutes to go or something. And we collapsed.
Yeah.
At the time, I didn't call it a collapse because you don't want to tell your kids you collapsed, but we collapsed. And we missed free throws from guys that shouldn't miss free throws. And we missed plays. And we turned the ball over. We just did everything you could possibly do to lose the game. But that was the moment. And I told our guys, they made that shot. And they jumped and celebrated like we did for the tournament.
Right.
And I said, they realize now that Bakersfield is here.
Right.
Because a team that with experience and a team that was not concerned, they'd have made the shot. Kind of high five, jumped up for a few minutes, they would have gone. They laid on our floor. And I told our guys, we will always remember that until we meet them again. We go to their place, and I thought, again, we kind of – they were winning the game sometime, right. But it was our game plan. And then we got there, and I never had a doubt during the tournament whether we were going to win or not. I really didn't. But our kids, like you said, they walked around, they talked like it, they believed it, and they lived.
My last question for you is, how can CSUB help improve the overall quality of basketball in Bakersfield and Kern County? I mean, we've had a lot of good players, you know, Ty Wallace at Cal, Braxton Huggins, who's in Mexico State. You know, your son is on the team, and he had a nice career at Liberty. What can CSUB do to help with that?
Well, I think, first of all, there's just awareness. I mean, people want to win. Mm-hmm. I mean, no matter how we draw this up, people want to win. They want to be associated with a winner. It's important to be part of a winning team. And now that we're winning, people are starting to do that. But I also think that people here in Bakersfield have to embrace the kids that are here.
Right.
To say, hey, it's okay to go to CSUB. It's okay to go to Bakersfield. We have arrived, and they need to root for us like that.
Right. I don't think you need to worry about that. We're out of time, Coach.
Thank you.
You are a brilliant, brilliant man. I think people compare us a lot. I think they get a lot of that.
Well, I'm trying to work my way up to be like you.
You hang
day.
In there. You're going to get
I'm
there.
I'm working
you
at
are on
it
a track. You're on track, my friend. You're right there. I got high hopes. Coach Roddy Barnes, man, seriously, this whole town is so proud of you and proud of those kids. Well done, man.
Well, thank you.
We got to get out of here. Stay tuned for the Money Wise Guys, Miles Savage, Ralph Bailey Show. Tomorrow, somebody thought it'd be a good idea to let Dick Taylor on the program, so we'll do that. Terry and Kate will be here from the ADAKC. Lois Henry's triumphant return. That's a lot going on. You don't want to miss any of it, so don't. You get tired, pull over. You get hungry, eat something. Go Runners.